Hi there, here's another highly requested video for you guys. Tips and tricks for the view 4K premium TV. Tips and tricks are nothing but features that you might have missed out on and might come handy. Some of you might have already figured them out, some of you haven't. But this video is gonna be helpful for everyone, so you don't wanna miss it. But before we begin, subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so that you don't miss any update. Also follow me on my social media handles for more tech info. This is your friend Tech Singh. Let's get started. So firstly, for this demo, I'm using the 55-inch View 4K Premium Android TV. The tips and tricks shown in this video will work across all View Premium TV series. All right, let's start. Now, I'm sure we're consuming loads of content online on our smart TVs during this lockdown, and there must have been a time when you quickly want to rewind a scene, forward a song, or pause from your remote. But there are no such controls on your remote, right? Wrong. Here, at the bottom of the remote, you can see Playpad. Press this, and you will see a virtual keys on the TV. You can navigate left, right using the D-pad on the remote. You also have an option to place this bar on the upper part of the display in case you have problems seeing the scroll bar. Now, the best part about this is it works on default media players, including VLC player and all apps, YouTube, Netflix, Prime Videos, Hotstar, you name it and it works. Perfect for apps like YouTube and Prime Videos where it doesn't scroll back or forth with the D-pad on the remote. On Netflix, it does. Here is where the Playpad comes very handy. Now you don't have to go to the scroll bar anymore. Just press Playpad quickly and move back and forth with one click on the remote. This is a very helpful tool that everyone must use. So next is the RGYB button on the remote. It basically stands for the colors red, green, yellow and blue. So when you press this, you can see four dots of these colors on the display. They basically work as shortcuts for many apps. Like for example, in Amazon Prime app, green means add to watchlist, blue is for search, yellow is for going back to the home page on Prime Videos. So if you see these colors as shortcuts in any app, you can click on the RGYB button and select the color from it. Coming to the power button. So when you press it once, it wakes up the TV. When you press it again, it goes back in standby mode. Perfect. But what if you have to restart the TV or completely switch it off? You press and hold the power button for more options. You will see the options to power off and restart. I really like the idea that the TV goes in standby when pressed once and wakes up almost instantaneously when pressed again. Saves a hell lot of time. But I highly recommend you turn off the TV once in a while, especially if it is not going to be used for a couple of days. Also, that would help save some power. Another handy feature on the remote is the menu key. It is the button with three horizontal lines. When pressed while running an app, it makes changes only to the specific app or input source. Like now, I'm in YouTube and I press the menu button. You can change the picture settings. I'm changing it from standard to dynamic and backlight to 50. In sound settings, I'm changing from standard to theater. Okay, now I'm going to the Netflix app. Pressing the menu key, and here you can see that the picture setting is still showing standard and backlight as 100 and sound is also showing as standard. So basically, you can set different picture settings, backlight settings, and sound settings for every app or input source as per your preference. Isn't this brilliant? Suppose you watch a lot of cricket on the Hotstar app. So you can set the picture settings to cricket mode only for the Hotstar app, making this feature extremely helpful. Also in the menu is the audio only option. Now we listen to a lot of music on our TVs from so many apps like Gaana, Spotify, and everyone's favorite YouTube. But you don't want to keep the display on. So you press the menu key and here you can see audio only. Click it when music is playing. The display turns off and the audio keeps playing. It's amazing. And if you want to wake the display, just press any button on the remote and the display wakes up. This feature really comes very, very handy. There is also a sleep timer option for those who watch TV late night and fall asleep. You can simply set the sleep timer. Go to the settings, advanced systems, power and sleep timer. You can set it from 10 minutes to 120 minutes. Since we're talking about timers, how about setting a wake up timer on your TV? Go to the settings, advanced systems, and you have timer. You can set on timer and off timer. You can set the time to turn on and off, and you can even choose if you want to do it once or daily. Ideal for those who want to wake up in the morning and watch their part, puja channels, or even news. I'm just saying. And finally, last but not the least, such a cliche line, last but not the least. But anyway, so here's the last one. If you have wall-mounted your View Premium TV, then to enjoy the optimal audio experience, go to the settings, sound, And below here, you will find wall mount setup. Turn it on. What it does, it improves vocal and audio surround accordingly. The sound is pushed downwards and not behind. Trust me, if you turn this on when your TV is wall mounted, it really makes a huge difference. So, here are the tips and tricks for the Vue Premium TV. Some of them might even work for the Vue Cinema TV. I like that you try them. Also, I hope this video was helpful. Write in the comments and let me know if there are any new features that you have found out that I haven't discovered. Leave them down in the comments and it'll be helpful for all. Also, before I end this video, a gentle reminder, keep social distancing, eat healthy, wash your hands in regular intervals, and stay safe. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Until next time, cheers.